Shri Ganeshaya Namaha Om Shri Sarasvatyai Namaha Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Om Samasta Jana Kalyane Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Om Shuklam Varadharam Vishnam Shashivaranam Chaturbhujam Prasanna Vadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vighno Pashantaye Vyasam Vasishta Naptaram Shakte Pautramakalmasam Parasharatmajam Vande Shukatatam Taponidhim Vyasaya Vishnu Rupaya Vyasa Rupaya Vishnave Namo Vai Brahma Nidhaye Vasishtaya Namo Namaha Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanura Mardanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagat Gurum Krishnam Vande Jagat Gurum Om Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudirayet Om Namo Vasishtaya Mahavrataya Parasharam Vedanidhim Namasye Namostvanantaya Mahoragaya Namostu Siddhebhya Yakshayebhyah Namostu Rishibhya Paramam Paresham Deveshu Devam Varadam Varanam Sahasrashirshaya Namashivaya Sahasranamaya Janardhanaya We studied so far, we began our study with Śānti Parva. So Śānti Parva, Anuśāsana Parva are the teachings of Bhīṣmācāryaji. Then afterwards after these two parvas, that is Shanti and Anuśāsana, we studied Aśvamedhika Parva. Yudhishthira becoming the king and performing the Aśvamedha Yajna. And afterwards, we saw Āśramavāsika Parva. Because 12th Parva is Shanti Parva. 13th Anuśāsana. 14th Aśvamedhika Parva. So, 15th Parva we saw Āśramavāsika Parva, where they moved to forest. Who? Dhritarashtra, Gandhari, Kunti, Sanjaya and Vidura. We saw them, Āśramavāsika Parva. And then, next we saw Mausala Parva, Mahāprasthānika and Svargārohaṇa. So, Śānti, Anuśāsana, Āśvamedhika, Āśramavāsika, Mausala, Mahāprasthānika and Svargārohaṇa. All these parvas we saw. Seven of them. Then we came to Adi Parva, Sabhā Parva, Vana Parva, then Udyoga Parva, all those parvas we saw. So, what is left now is Bhīṣma, Droṇa, Karṇa, Shalya, Sauptika, Stri. Six parvas are left. Okay? So, in these six parvas, now we will start today with Bhīṣma Parva. Anyway, we shall start with Bhishma Parva today. Bhishma Parva is important because of two reasons. One is the Bhagavad Gita is given here. Teachings of Bhagavad Gita we find in this chapter, Parva. And also, a very detailed account of the war each combat exhaustively given in this Bhishma Parva, which speaks about the first 10 days of the war. So, in this Parva, Bhishmacharya, on the 10th day, he falls down. It is about 122 chapters or so, if I am correct. And this chapter, major portion is Bhagavad Gita. This Parva, major portion is Bhagavad Gita. So let us see. And we saw in the previous Parva, Udyoga Parva, it's a wonderful Parva. We saw lot of discussions, dialogues, Sanat Sujatiyam, Viduraniti, so much of the Bhagavan Krishna's as a messenger, what all, Sanjay as a messenger, Krishna as a messenger, so many things we saw in Udyoga Parva, which was very actually heavy. Now let us see, in Bhishma Parva, first one is Jambukanda Vinirmana Parva, first one, Upaparva, Jambukanda, Jambudvipa. Now in this, entire the lokas, the globe, its continents, all these things are described by Sanjaya to Dhritarashtra. He asks some questions. Let us see now, what is it now? So, Prathamodhyayaha. Now here, Janmajaya asked, Janmajaya vacha katham yujudhire viraha kuru pandava somakaha parthiva sumahatmanu nana desha samagataha. Now see, Maharaj, who is asked? No, Mahabharata was told by whom? By Vaishampanji. To Janmajaya. So Janmajaya asked the question, how they know, did Kauravas, Pandavas, and also the heroes of Somaka Vamsha, Visa Somakas, who are they? As well as many kings, they come, and how did the fight begin? How did the fight go on? That is the question. Asked by, slowly I am going. During Bhagavad Gita, I will increase my speed. So we will be happy. We know Gita only directly. But here we don't know many things. Let us see now. So Vaishampanji started. We will read one or two slokas and then see. Yatha yujudhire viraha kuru pandava somakaha kurukshetre tapakshetre surunutvam prithvipate tevateriya kurukshetram pandava saha somakaha kaurava samavartanta jigishanto mahabalaha. Now see, Vaishampanji says, now say, Maharaj, listen now, O Janmajaya. You know, all these, both the sides, that is Kaurava side as well as Pandava side, both of them are very mighty in their strength. Hum kisi se kam nahi, that is the meaning. And that is true. Because we find in Mahabharata war, they were not compromising. Whatever they believed in, the Kauravas also believed in their own principles, adharma. Pandavas believed in dharma. When they came to fight, both were willing to die. So courage was one thing commonly seen in both the things, both these teams. Fully courageous. And they have made up their minds to die. So Mother De Tyakta Jeevitaha, he already said, no, Duryodhana. They assembled here to give up even their lives. So here Vaishampanji says, both are very keen to win the battle. Both of them are keen. And all of them are well versed in the knowledge of the Vedas, and they praise, that is war. They always praise war because Kshatriya dharma, and it is a dharma for Kshatriyas, therefore they glorify the war. So they glorify the war. They are very equally strength and strong and mighty, both of them. Both of them are well versed in Vedas, and both of them are keen to win the battle. So both these huge forces gathered there on earth about 5000 years back. And we saw also earlier, Pandavas, they went and occupied the I don't know how many of you seen Kurukshetra. This is the north now. So western side of the Kurukshetra field. So both the armies occupied the western portion of the Kurukshetra field. But in that western portion, Pandavas were facing the east and Kauravas were facing the west. That means Kaurava's camp is closer to the field. They can run quickly and get their ammunitions. Pandavas are little farther, but they are facing east. These fellows are facing west. So both of them, Kauravas and Pandavas, both of them occupied the western side of the Kurukshetra war field. Okay? And then, you can refer this also in chapter 195 of 11th Sloka Udyoga Parvam. It said that Kauravas also occupied the western side of the Kurukshetra field. That means both the sides occupied the western side of the Kurukshetra field only, but Pandavas were facing the east and Kauravas perhaps they were facing the western side, because it is said their tents are opposite to each other, facing opposite to each other. Okay. Yudhishthira, now Vaishampanji continues. He had constructed, can anybody garam pani chudla sakte? Thoda gala mein gadbad, keech keech. Advertisement is there, no? So Yudhishthira, he had constructed thousands of tents away from the war field. That Yudhishthira also, he had created thousands of tents. Do you remember? Duryodhana also had constructed a visitor's gallery. You don't forget that. Visitor's gallery was constructed. For them, rooms were constructed for them to stay and watch the war. It was constructed. And all the regions, now you see, what's happening now? Everybody gathered. So what is the scene there? The scene was like this. All the regions of earth, all the khandas, all the countries, all the regions of this prithvi, they are seen wherever you look at. They are every village, every town, every country, every region on the earth is seen without youth in their own respective places. Meaning all of them gathered here. Right? And only children and the aged ones, old people, alone are seen in every gaon, every village, every town. You will come across only, perhaps only the sick youth were lying down at home. Otherwise, youth are all the people who are middle-aged and yavana, dasha. Everybody gathered there in the war field. And all earth has become emptied. He says, Vaishampanji says in 7th sloka, he says very important. He says, shunya cha prithvi sarva bala vriddha avasheshitah nirashva purashevasid ratha kunjara varjitah. Ratha kunjara varjitah. Shunya cha prithvi sarva. Whole earth has become empty. Shunya. Shunya of what? Bala vriddha avasheshitah. See, all the, and accepting old people and children, earth has become emptied. Everybody gathered. Nirashva purushe vasit rathakunjara varjitaha. Very, very important slokas. Samanta panchakat bhagya shibirani sahasrashah karayavasa vidivat kunti putro idhishthiraha and yavat tapati suryohi jambu dvipasya mandalam tavadeva samayatam balam parthiva sattama. As you see, when earth, from the space you can see some pictures also. Earth, you know, when it is shedding its rays, and as far as in a given particular time, earth is spreading its rays in Jambudvipa. One particular big huge time, huge field. All the Jambudvipa may is entire, you know, whatever Jambudvipa is covered by the sun with his rays, from all those regions, all the forces have assembled in Kurukshetra to fight. Imagine now. It's a huge population. And he says, Ye kasta sarvavarnahate mandalam bahuyojanam paryakra mantadeshanscha nadihi shailan vananicha. Wonderful it is. Ye kasta sarvavarnahate. You know, all varnas, caste, all creeds, everybody gathered there. Ye kasta. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Varnas, everybody gathered there. And the tents in the war, Mandalam, Bahuyojanam. the tents which are constructed and the place that they occupied, then mandalam and bahuyojanam, that field, the war field spread many, many yojanas, miles it has spread. That is area where they are residing when they occupied. And all of them, jitna aap jahan milta jagah, he said, therefore, sir, pariyakramanta deshanscha nadihi shailan vanaricha. These people, entire army, have occupied what? The rivers, mountains, and forests from all sides. But there is no place. And Yudhishthira, Tesham, Yudhishthiro Raja, Sarvesham, Purusharshabha, Vyadidesha, Savakyanam, Bhakshabhojyam Anuttamam. You know, whatever, you know, Yudhishthira, you know, it is said here, he had made all the arrangements for their food and also provided cots for them to sleep in the nights. Imagine the amount of preparation. In the last parva, ending May, मैं आपको एक नोट्स आई जस्ट ट्राई टू गिव यू ए कलेक्टिव पिक्चर ऑफ व्हाट अमाउंट ऑफ अरेंजमेंट्स वुड हैव बीन मेड और दे वर मेड रेदर एट वंस मेडिकल टीम सो मेनी थिंग्स माइंड बॉगलिंग व्यवस्था इट वॉज एंड ही ऑल्सो प्रेजेंटेड डिफरेंट बैडजेस आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड ऑर्नामेंट्स फॉर देयर आइडेंटिफिकेशन दैट मीन्स वॉट All of them were provided, and this is only to know that they belong to Pandava side. Similarly, Duryodhana also did same thing. And Duryodhana, he had made his strategies for the war. Yaad rakhna, ye sab one day before the war. The next day war begins. So, he was standing in the midst of 1000 elephants, and somebody was holding a white umbrella, and who is standing on the other side of the Pandava camp in the midst of huge thousands, and white big umbrella was held over his head, and Duryodhana was standing in the midst of all his army. Imagine how he would be standing there. He must be standing. Now, Panchala warriors, the warriors of Panchala, Dushtajumna, Drupada, and their cousin Somakavamshi, all those things, Panchala warriors, they felt very happy after seeing Duryodhana. Because mil gaya bachaj, was so happy. They were happy that now at last we are able to see him, so that we will finish him off soon. So they blew their conches and trumpets. Pehle kab? Ek din pehle ki baat main keh raha hu. Acha. Then looking at the inspiration of the warriors on Pandava side, all the Pandavas and in particular Bhagavan Krishna also felt very happy. Because, you know, Pandava side may, they are looking at their inspiration with which, you know, they are all gathered. And look, seeing Duryodhana, they all, out of inspiration, joy, they blew conches and blew, trumpets, etc. So, Bhagavan Krishna observed this, the inspiration in their team. Pandavas, both of them felt happy to see the inspirational levels in the Pandava side. Achha. And Bhagavan and Krishna, both of them also blew their conches very happily, comfortably seated in their chariots. Next day morning is the war. Now, many soldiers on the enemy side, they were horrified. Horripilations were there. They were scared because after listening to the blow of the conches of Bhagavan Krishna and Arjuna, they all got very scared, as if they heard a lion's roar in their ears, you know, directly. And they lost all their inspiration after listening to their conches, blow of conches. It is said there in this sloka, Panchajanyasya nirghosham devadattasya cha ubhayoho srutvatu niradam yodaha shakrun mutram prasasravuhu. They urinated, immediately listening to that. Dar ke. Malamutra visarjan karne lage. And they all lost there. That means what? They are all not in the war field. Remember this. Main bar bar keh raha hu. War field mein nahi hai. Field is different. But they are in their own, what do you call that? Base camp. What do you, I don't know. Camp. Huh? Base camp. No, other camp was told. Concentration camp. Correct word I want. 37 सेक्टर में करेक्ट वर्ड मिलना मिलता है, और कहीं बाहर ये किया हो तो जो भी है बोलते जाओ, बट यहां पे करेक्ट वर्ड यूज करना है, कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कैंप। ओके नाउ तब क्या हुआ, देन बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मूवमेंट ऑफ द सोल्जर्स ब्लो ऑफ कैंचर्स ट्रम्पट साउंड वॉज क्रिएटेड सो द डस्ट रोज इन टू द स्काई एंड इट कवर्ड ऑल द स्पेस। नथिंग इज विजिबल टू एनी वन एट दैट टाइम, द डिन एंड रोर बोलते हैं ना, नथिंग इज विजिबल एंड डस्ट रोज एंड इट लुक्ड लाइक द सन इज सेट फॉर द डे। सब लोग सोचने लगे कि सूर्य भगवान का अस्तमय हो गया, क्योंकि द एंटायर डस्ट स्प्रेड ऑल द स्पेस। देयर आफ्टरवर्ड्स देयर वर वेरी हेवी हिंट्स लिफ्टिंग एंड थ्रोइंग स्मॉल स्टोन्स एंड मड कैरिंग द व्हाट यू कॉल small small pebbles small stones etc mud etc and it started hurting all the soldiers, heavy winds cyclonic winds type and the gathering of the forces on the two sides was like two huge oceans facing each other, it was like the meeting of the oceans at the time of dissolution। pralay kal mein sara sagar ek ho jata hai na, it's a meeting happily, Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea shake hand, so hamare beech mein kya hoga humko, and there afterwards thoda subside ho gaya, then kauravas mukhya pandavas and also somakavamshis everybody they came and they made certain rules of war। What are the rules of war you want to know? Very important। And you know how they broke the rules. Number one, after the end of the war every day, that is sham mein suryasta mein hote hi khatam karna yuddh, let there be mutual love between all of us, aapas mein prem bani rahe, badhiya hai na। एनिमीज ओनली बिटवीन कौरवास एंड बस भाई फर्स्ट रूल यू कोलैप्स्ड, दैट इज हाउ दे फॉट, दे सेट द रूल्स, नो वन शुड बिहेव विथ एनिमिटी एट दैट टाइम टुवर्ड्स एनी वन। शत्रुभाव मन में रख के कोई भी किसी के प्रति व्यवहार नहीं करना चाहिए, ये पहला रूल है। आई डिडंट कम अक्रॉस दैट पॉइंट एनीवेयर बट इट इज सेट बाय महात्मास। For all of them, there used to be only one kitchen। रात में भोजन करते थे, तुम कौरों के वो पौंडों के कुछ भी नहीं, डाइनिंग हॉल में घुसो अपना थाली लो खाओ बस, हरिओम हरिओम, ऑल ऑफ द रिलेटिव्स ओनली, नो आई डिडंट सी यू इन अवर साइड, नो आई एम फाइटिंग फ्रॉम अदर साइड, ओ आई सी आई सी आई सी आई डिडंट सी यू, या आई नो दैट, how come you are on that side, doesn't matter for a change, okay that is a talk, must be they must have talked like that in dining hall। Acha second one, those very interesting point, those who are engaged in verbal fight, that means there are some warriors, their job is they don't know how to fight with any astra shastra but they are experts in verbal fight, ऐसा गाली दो कि दूसरा व्यक्ति उठ के भागे, दैट इज देयर एक्सपर्टाइज। दोज हु आर एंगेज्ड इन वर्बल फाइट, ओनली वर्बल फाइट शुड बी एंगेज्ड अगेंस्ट देम। सपोज वर्बल फाइट, आई वांट वर्बल फाइट, एंगेज इन वर्बल फाइट, यू वांटेड टू ब्रिंग आउट विद रिवॉल्वर और बाउ एरो एटसेट्रा, नो आई एम वर्बल फाइट, तुम्हारा अस्त्र क्या है, वर्बल वाग्धाटी, अच्छा चलो फिर आई विल एंगेज विथ यू ओनली इन वर्बल फाइट, हाथ नहीं लगाना, छूना नहीं, दूर दूर बैठो, गाली देते रहो एक दूसरे को, वंडरफुल नो, लाइक सम डॉग्स ऑल्सो डू सेम थिंग, नो दे डोंट मीट दे डोंट फाइट, फेसेस आर सो क्लोज दे कम टूगेदर एंड देन दे डिसअपीयर्स। अच्छा सेकेंड रूल इज ओवर, देयर इज नो वेपन्स एट ऑल for those who engage in verbal fight। Third, those who move out of the war field, they should never be killed। जो रणभूमि छोड़ के बाहर जाता है ना, उनको कोई भी व्यक्ति मारना नहीं चाहिए. व्हाट अ रूल है. Nowadays, if you follow these rules, nobody can fight. Better be peaceful. Achha. Now, ye rathi. Rathi means, you know, that one who is capable of fighting. The strength, look, ranks. A rathi should fight only with rathi. So similarly, an elephant fighter sitting on an elephant who fights, he should fight only with another elephant fighter. Similarly, a horse fighter should fight with another horse fighter. And a foot soldier should fight with another foot soldier only. Equals only they should fight. जो हाथी पे बैठ के युद्ध कर रहा है ना, वो घोड़े वाला मार नहीं सकता. और वैसी वर्षा. रूल नंबर फोर. और फोर रूल्स है. हाँ, वन शुड डिक्लेयर. फर्स्ट डिक्लेयर, अपने आप को डिक्लेयर करना चाहिए. And make enemy alert before the fight itself. My so and so, I would like to kill you and engage with you in fighting in this manner. Be ready. And finding out what? One's yogyata, ichcha and utsaha of the... You should find out these three and then choose an opponent. What a my God. Means what? Yogyata, capability. Other opponent, is he capable of fighting with me? Yogyata. He is a yogya purusha for me to fight with. If he is above than me, then the other man should think, he is not yogya to me to fight with. Therefore, he should not fight with me. If he is lower to me, he is not yogya to me. Therefore, I should not fight with. So, yogyata, ichcha, desire. Suppose we are same equals, but I don't want to fight with you. You are MBA, I am MBA. Chalo, let us fight. No, I don't want to fight with you specifically. Why? I don't like your face. Or I love you. I can't fight with you. Full stop. So I don't wish to fight with you. I don't want to choose you as my enemy or opponent. Then you should not fight. Desire. And inspiration. Utsaha. Yogyata might be there. But every yogya purusha may not be always utsahi. We are all yogya. We are yogyata is there in us, but we may not have inspiration all the time. Inspiration fluctuates. So the rate of fluctuation of inspiration is much, much higher than the rate of fluctuation of yogyata. I think you understood this point. If you are a yogyata, at least it will remain with you for some time, at least 6 months or 1 year or 1 month or 2 months or 1 year or a few years. Before you upgrade your knowledge and skills. But utsaha, fluctuation of inspiration is much higher than the fluctuation of yogyata. So utsaha also to be seen. And then strength, bala, and then choose the opponent. My God. So I can't fight with anybody. I can't, you know, spray bullets. No. This is another rule they formed. And next rule is, those who are scared of war while fighting should never be attacked. Meaning what? Yuddha kartya samaye bhi, you should be courageous. Even at the time of your death also, if you are not courageously dying, if you are a little scared to fight with, then it is said that you should not be attacked. How many rules I told so far?
Five,
six. Seventh one. One is all seventh mein jo do teen hai. Seven, what is that? One who is seen engaged in fighting with someone. Suppose A is fighting with B. C cannot come and kill A or B. Or the one who took to surrender. I surrendered. I don't want to fight with you. Or the one who is running away from the battle. Jo ran chhod ke bhaag rahe ho. Aur jo sharanagati liye. And another one is also the one whose weapons haath se chutke niche gir gaya ho. Hathiyar. या वेपन्स, और कवच गिर गया, कवच गिर गया वो, या ना तो कट ऑफ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस युद्ध में इट मे ब्रेक. सच अ वॉरियर शुड नॉट बी किल्ड. धर्म युद्ध. Someone commented, a great Mahatma only, great person, well-read man. As long as Bhishmacharya is in the field, most of the dharmic rules were followed, most of them. When he went away, all adharma only with Duryodhana, when Dronacharya comes, you will see how it happened. They killed Abhimanyu. So much of adharma you see. And to counteract that, Pandavas also had to choose that. Like one, I'll give an example. Keep it as a permanent answer for all your queries. People generally ask, Bhagavan Krishna also adopted very crooked techniques. He was also not fair. A great, great Mahatma gave a wonderful answer for this. Because Bhagavan Krishna declared, Dharma Samasthapanarthaya Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. Okay. But in Yuddha, he himself adopted certain places, certain techniques. Answer was given. Wonderful answer. I told you this. You may have forgotten. What you may have, I don't know. You must have forgotten. See, there is a highway, there is a speed limit. Suppose on D&D road. What is the speed limit there? 80 kilometers, actually. 90 is a grace mark. 80 kilometer speed. Now there is a highway patrolling jeep also is there with some inspector to monitor the speed of the vehicles. Now 80 kilometers is speed. Now some vehicle is traveling with a speed of 140 kilometers and you can go. On the D&D, you can even touch 140, 150 also you can touch. Now the patrolling jeep inspector is there. He has to catch it. What should be his speed? No, he cannot follow his dharma. You cannot ask him. No, you must follow your dharma of 80 kilometers only. If he is following 80 kilometers speed on D&D road, he will never be able to catch the culprit. Now you understood? So Bhagavan Krishna had to take these decisions because he clearly declared dharma samasthapanartha. And if you see the Bhagavan's life, Krishna's life, one thing is clearly seen: absence of selfishness. If he want, he would have become king of the whole earth, but he says pagal hai, sari srushti meri hai, I am the Ishvara sarvabhutanam, I am the lord of all beings and also sarvalokanam. Why should I crave for petty paltry things on earth? I descended on earth only to establish dharma. So in order to catch the culprits, like a traffic inspector, he had to break the rule. Next one. Sutas. Sutas means the charioteers, you know, drivers. Who are appointed? Drivers, or no, not drivers. Sutas means those who are appointed to serve the horses. Ghas kilana, beech bhi paani pila sakte hai. You know, there in the war only, these people also used to supply water to horses. Kabhi kuch kilana ho, kabhi kuch dawa lagana ho, kabhi kuch patti bandhna ho. They are called serving the horses. And also weight bearers, carriers in the field. You go, एक हाथी गिर पड़ा है, रो रही है, इट हैज बी, सो दे ब्रॉट मस्ट हैव ब्रॉट सम व्हील, दिस वन पुल दिस एंड टेक द हाथी एलिफेंट आल्सो आउट ऑफ द फील्ड. अपार्ट फ्रॉम पीपल आल्सो, पीपल आल्सो हैव टू बी कैरीड सपोज, एंड हॉर्सेस हैव टू बी कैरीड, एंड आल्सो समवेयर सम फूड हैज टू बी सप्लाइड, मेडिकल टीम हैज टू अटेंड इन बिटवीन, दे मस्ट हैव देयर ओन यूनिफॉर्म. सो सच पीपल. And also suppliers of weapons. Immediately I call. I have my own assistant. He runs there. And he says that, no, unke rath mein ye baan ka, what do you call, khatam ho gaya hai. Arrows are over now. So some arrows are to be brought in. Somewhere the Dhanushka string, though they keep one or two spare, suppose they are exhausted, somebody has to bring the string of that for the bow also. Or I have kept four or five bows, all were broken, and in another bow. So they are called weapon carriers, etc. All those people who carry weapons to fighters, etc. As well as drum and trumpet blowers. Maybe to inspire a team, to inspire a battalion. अभी भी होता है कि नहीं? रात को everybody lost their inspiration. The commander has to arrange a little party, little dance, little even now he has to do even if it is on terrain, the mountains. Some kind of entertainment has to be done within the available means. Am I correct or not? कुछ कोई गाना गाओ, joke बोलो, हंसाओ, कुछ खिलाओ, पिलाओ, कुछ भी करो. So those people, such people should not be attacked. So in this way, Pandavas, Kauravas, Somakavamshis made rules of the war and remained. Afterwards, they remained surprised looking at each other. Meaning, maybe I don't know why they are surprised, because of many reasons. Utpreksha bahut laga sakte hain yahan pe. The rules are so good, difficult to follow. What if I break? Maybe surprised. There afterwards, they are all seen very happy with their forces. You are very happy with your team. That's the meaning. Now, iske baad, kya hua? We have seen the first chapter of Bhishma Parva. So far, second chapter. In this chapter, Vyasa Bhagavan bestows the power of clairvoyance to Sanjaya. Divya Drishti Pradhan Karta hai na, that is seen here. Vaishampayana Vacha, Vaishampanji consists. Thereafterwards, looking at the both the side of the forces standing opposite to each other, Yujutsakaha, with a desire to fight, both of them, Vyasa Bhagavan saw both the forces. Then, the knower of the past, the present and future, that is Vyasa Bhagavan, adjectives. Vaishampani says, the Sarvajna Veda Vyasa Rushi, Bhuta Bhavishyat Vartamana Jnana, jinke paas hai hamesha, that is the person, Vyasa Bhagavan. The grandfather of Bharata Vamshis, son of Satyavati, Bhagavan Vedavyasji, who was witnessing the consequences of the great war of this, who have been witnessing the developments of this between the armies, in this both the sides, he went to Dhritarashtra. It's a wonderful portion here. You must have patience to listen. So don't jump. Bhishma Parva kya hai? Bhagavad Gita. Baad mein aayega wo. Dhritarashtra was seen and he was drowned in the sorrow, thinking about their son's injustice. Not injustice towards their sons, injustice by his sons towards Pandavas. We have seen Dhritarashtra's character is highly fluctuating. जब नारद महर्षि के सामने या भगवान कृष्ण जी के सम्मुख या नहीं तो अच्छे विदुर जी के सम्मुख उनका क्लियर कट ज्ञान आ जाता है उनको. जैसा दुर्योधन आता है, ही ब्रिंग्स इट ओन ऑरा क्लाउड एंड ही कवर्स. वी सॉ दिस. सो नाउ ही वाज ड्राउन्ड एंड मोर ओवर ही न्यू दैट धर्म इज टुवर्ड्स पांडवास. ही न्यू दैट हिज सन्स आर अधर्मिक इन नेचर. सो ही वाज ड्राउन्ड इन सॉरो. So Bhagavan Vyasa ji spoke to him in private. What did he say? Vyasa uvacha, Rajan parita kalaste putraschanye cha parthivaha tehim santiva sangrame samasadyetaretaram teshu kala pariteshu vinashyat sveva bharata kala pariyaya magnyaya
māsmaśoke manakrutāha yadicchechasi saṅgrāme drashtum etān viṣāmpate chakṣur dadāni te putra yuddham tatra niṣāmaya.
He says, Vyāsa uvacha, O Raja, the time of death had arrived. Vināśakāla had approached now. For whom? For all your sons, as well as for other kings who are supporting your sons. O Bhagavan, O Raja, Abhikal upasthit ho gaya. Aagaya paas mein. Now the time had come, destructive time. Now, Vyasa said, they both are ready, they are ready to fight with each other. And they are ready to get killed in the war. And when they are about to destroy themselves, swayed by time, seeka, kala pariyayam agnyaya, swayed by time, they have already, they have decided, swayed by kala, they are about to destroy themselves, you should not grieve now, knowing all this to be the play of time. Please come to know that this is all game of time. Coming to know, you please know this, and having understood that this is all game of time, play of time, you should not grieve. Kala Mahima. In everybody's life, there are some bright times, there are some dark times. Sometimes chamak, 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 chamak. At once, whole family is drowned in sorrow. Suddenly, pall of gloom descends. Oh Raja, if you wish to see their condition during the war, how your children would fight, what is their condition, I will bestow upon you a special vision. See? Chakshur dadānite putra yuddham tatra viṣāmaya. I will bestow upon you a special vision, and you will be able to see all the happenings in the war sitting in your own palace, on your own throne, like a direct relay, with a remote in your hand to shift the screen or a camera in whichever direction you want. I want to see the fight there. That portion. Here I want to say, yahan pe kya ho raha hai? I will bestow upon you. Dhritarashtra uvacha. Dhritarashtra said, Maharaj, he said, I don't wish to see my own family members getting killed in the war. Now see, he knew that they will be killed. He never said that, I don't wish to see Pandavas getting killed. He never said. But he said, my family members, including Pandavas perhaps. But bless me, so that I will be able to listen to the commentary. All the things happening in the war field, by your grace. So I must listen what's all happening there in the field, but I should not see. Abhi bhi na? रेडियो कमेंट्री सुनना आसान है, देखने में बीपी बढ़ जाएगा. क्रिकेट मैच स्पेशली, बिकॉज यू नो रेडियो कमेंट्री ऑडियो इज आफ्टर द इफेक्ट. वो पहुंच ही गया चक्का, वो बाद में बोलेगा, आगे आया उठाया, उठ गया वो वहां पे फेल्ड ऑलरेडी थ्रो बैक. बट बाय द टाइम यू सेल टेल दिस, यू लिसन टेक्स टाइम. एंड व्हेन यू आर सीइंग visually in the television what's all happening there, direct relay tension, because you carry their tension on their faces also, you import download with the tension. I don't want to see this, but I would like to listen. So Vaishampanji says, O Janamejaya, Bhagwan Vyasji now understood that Dhritarashtra doesn't want to see the war, but he wants to listen to the details of the war. Then he bestowed this boon to Sanjaya, and he told Sanjaya, what did he say to Sanjaya? Let us see now. Raja, Dhritarashtra, what? To Dhritarashtra, Vyasji was telling, O king, equipped with this Divya Drishti, Sanjaya will become sarvajna. Now see the underlining this word. I am not giving only a view for only for war, but I have to give him a wholesome packet. So with this blessing, Sanjaya would become sarvajna and he will narrate all the happenings in the war. Sarvajna means what? Bhavishyat jnanam also he knew. Vartamana jnanam also he knows. And past also he knows. Loka jnanam he knows. Lokantara jnanam also he got it. Are you listening carefully? Not only of this world, but whole cosmic knowledge also he gained now. He says, Vyasa Bhagavan says, anything manifested or unmanifested during the day or the night, and also the thoughts of the in the mind of any person, Sanjaya will come to know them all. Dekhiye, vyakta, avyakta. Whatever is in avyakta sthiti, whatever is in vyakta sthiti, number one. Night me, ya rahto, day me, during the day or in the night. And also the thoughts in the mind of the person, Sanjaya will come to know as it is. Badhiya hai na? Moreover, Vyasa Bhagavan says, no weapon can cut him. He would not feel stress and strain. And Vyasa Bhagavan said, this Gavalgana Putra, that is Sanjaya, will survive this Mahabharata war. That means what? He can wander in the war field. No weapon strikes him. No harm can be done, can reach him. Nothing. He is totally protected. In fact, he need not go to the war field to know what's happening in the war. Why? He becomes sarvajna. This knowledge. Then Vyasa Bhagavan said, oh Dhritarashtra, I will spread the fame of Kauravas and Pandavas in all the three worlds. You don't grieve. That's why he wrote Mahabharata. I will spread this. Why? There is a lesson to be learned from Pandavas and Kaurava Charitra for the humanity. There is a great lesson that they have to learn. So now, what all happening? I will definitely spread the fame of Kauravas and Pandavas in all the three worlds. And this is the law of the divine. And nobody can challenge it. Vyasa Bhagavan said, therefore, you should not grieve. This is the justice of the divinity. That Kauravas and Pandavas would fight. Kauravas will die. Pandavas will regain their kingdom. Dharma samsthapanam takes place. This is the Ishvara Sankalpa. And therefore, please don't grieve this. Why? It would happen like this only. And you know, O Dhritarashtra, victory takes place on the side of dharma. So Vaishampani continued, as a bolke, Vyasa Bhagavan again continued to Dhritarashtra. He said, great number of human beings will be killed in this war. A report was read, you know, scientific report, somewhere it comes. 90 crore people died. He reports this too. That's for you don't count as per the only Mahabharata me, the one Akshauhini count. They are called actually chief people. But many, many people were added, included in that. Immature people, you know. They are not counted. So Yudhishthira reports this to Dhritarashtra after the war. Earth was thickly populated at that time. And of course, this entire India means, Bharatakanda means not only our part now. This Pakistan, Burma, all those things, Bangladesh, so many things, Nepal, everything is included in this Bharata, Bhumi, one plane, Khanda. And that is Akhanda Bharat. Wherever you can travel on the land, touching the shores of the ocean, that is actually Akhanda Bharat. That is called Prithvi Pate. Samudra Paryantam Prithvi, that is the meaning. That was the one which was ruled by Yudhishthira. Anyway, 5000 years gone, so many changes. So, a great number of human beings will be killed in this war. And Vyasa Bhagavan says, now I am seeing omens, bad omens, indicating this great disaster in the human history. Vyasa Bhagavan says. And now onwards, we will be seeing how many women's bad things, unnatural things occurred at that time before the Mahabharata war was exhaustively narrated by Veda Vyasa Bhagavan. Some of them only we will see. Are you ready? Number one, hawks and vultures, crows and herons, together with the cranes, are seen settling on the top of the trees and are gathering in great numbers around the war field. For what purpose? And they sense, no, extra, they have their own sense perception. These birds are extremely happy looking at the war field very closely. This indicates that these flesh-eating birds will eat the flesh of the dead horses and elephants. Fierce herons are also uttering merciless cries and moving in southern region. Both in the morning and evening, twilights, sandhya, udaya, ushakala sandhya, and also evening sandhya, during this evening sandhyas, in the both the sandhya, during my sandhya vandan time, when I perform a sandhya, I see Surya Bhagavan covered by kavandas. Kavandas means are headless trunks. Different beings are covering. I behold day and night all the stars and the sun also burning constantly. There is no difference between day and the night. This indicates a great fear. Meaning temperature in the night also gone up. As though sun is there. Burning. Moon is seen without its splendor on Kartika Purnima. Kartika Purnima then? You know. But it is seen without splendor. And therefore, it was not visible. Or not having its own hue, original hue, nothing. And the consequences of this would be that the strong fighter kings, great fighter kings, who has broad and strong shoulders, very mighty people, they will die in the war and they cover the whole earth that with their dead bodies. Vyasa Bhagavan says, I am seeing, O Yudhishthira, O Dhritarashtra, I see daily in the nights jumping boars and cats, boar, varaha, and cats fighting each other heavily in the nights. The idols of the gods sometimes shiver on their own, sometimes smile and sometimes vomit blood and sometimes they fall down. Drums play automatically without anybody playing on them. And the big chariots of the Kshatriya are seen moving without horses yoked to them. Meaning, invisible forces took control of the earth. Understood? Invisible forces hai na bahut hai. They are now freely taking charge. Kokila, that you know. Woodpeckers, jaws, watercocks, parrots, crows, and peacocks, they are uttering terrible cries. You can notice, no, when birds are crying also. Dogs cry also, you can notice. Cat cry also, you can notice. When cat is crying constantly, you know, you people bhaga dete. Very upper, bad thing to listen to that cry. Dar bhi lagta hai kabhi kabhi. Kutta bhi raat ko, huh? I can mimic and show, but then I will not. And picture में ही दिखाते हैं ना रात को शमशान दिखाना हो direction anyway at sunrise flights of insects you know by hundreds are seen in twilights both the sandhyas में the cardinal quarters the direction seemed to be ablaze and the clouds shower dust and flesh meaning You know, so many flesh means here, so many things can be interpreted. Maybe dropping of dead bodies by animals, by birds, so many things. And Arundhati Nakshatra had made Vasishta, her husband, settle at the back. You know, if you see Arundhati, I don't know how many of you know where is she. Saptarshi Mandala, second star. Vasishta, Arundhati. Arundhati is a small dot. So Vasishta is shown, Vasishta to Arundhati is shown. Okay. Here, Arundhati Nakshatra had made her husband Vasishta settle at the back, meaning what? Husbands fade in this war and wives alone live. And they become bright, what you call, since the bright portion of their lives, that is, their husbands will not be alive after their war. They become bright means what? They have to come and forefront. They should take charge of husband's responsibilities of family, etc. They must become active. It is clearly seen in the constellation also. Planet Shani, only few only I am telling now. Lot of the things are given here. Shani Nakshatra, Graha, is seen afflicting Rohini constellation. The sign of the deer on the moon, the deer sign is there on the moon, has deviated from its usual position. A great terror is indicated with this, he says. Who? Vyasa Bhagavan. Even though there are no clouds, but terrible thunders are heard, animals are all weeping, and their tears are falling on the ground. Vyasa Uvacha continues. Oh Raja, now see, it happened, stray incidents are noticed. Here and there we come across, we read in newspapers, but they happened in a very higher scale at that time. Donkeys are born from cows. The trees in the forest are giving flowers and fruits during off seasons. Pregnant ladies are giving birth to terrible beings but not human beings. Flesh-eating birds take food along with other animals in the same place. Meaning, actually both should show enmity towards each other, is it not? But both of them are so happy to see the more dead bodies, so there is no need competition between them. Animals with three horns, some with four eyes, some with five legs, some with two sexual organs, some with two heads, some with two tails, and some with many teeth, with their mouths wide open, uttering terrible cries are seen. Wives of many Vedic Brahmanas are giving birth to Garudas, eagles and peacocks. She horses are giving birth to cows. Some women are giving birth to 4 to 5 baby girls. Abhi bhi kabhi dekhte hai na? That stay there, kabhi kabhi that mark is still there in nature. These girls are seen dancing and laughing as soon as they are born. You see nowadays, no, one brain, two bodies, or joined babies, horrible. My God. This is all what? Vikruti in Prakruti. So many things, you know. Somebody born so many things. And small children are attacking other children with the weapons in their hands. This is happening even now. They make fake cities. Fake cities means they construct fake cities and enact mutual fights. Okay. And they said, Vyasa Bhagavan says, there are terrible winds and dust spreading everywhere. Earth is seen trembling again and again. Rahu is going nearer to the sun. Gati of these astrological constellations. Ketu had transgressed the Chitra Nakshatra and moving towards Swati. And during the Mahabharata war, Rahu and Ketu came to same house or constellation. Actually, they separated by 7 houses, no? Same constellation. Rahu and Ketu together. So, astronomical positions, still they are explained. I am avoiding them. By Vyasa Bhagavan for about 7-8 slokas next. How each nakshatra, their placement, which is affecting which one, the constellations, everything is given here. Now, continuing, the earth that produces a particular crop in a particular season is now seen with crops of all seasons. Meaning what? Timely harvest is not there. Even now we are doing a hybrid grain. Even in November you get an aam, mango. These all unnatural things, not tuned to nature. And cows are yielding blood from their udders after their cows had their milk from the udders. For cows they are giving milk. When others try to take milk out of the udder, blood is coming out. Meaning what? Even now it's happening, no? The Jersey cows, machines are applied to take the milk and then they scream in pain. Animal torture. And sometimes blood also comes. A great slaughter of human beings and animals will take place surely. All the weapons are blazing forth radiantly. Earth will become a river of blood. Animals and birds on all sides are uttering terrible cries. All these, O Maharaja, foretell terrible consequences. In the nights, a bird having only one eye, one wing and one leg flies, uttering terrible cries, crying. The sound of its cry is like the sound produced when a person vomits blood. All weapons are looking like burning. Saptarshi Mandala has become dimmed in its radiance. Brihaspati and Shani, these two blazing planets, they have remained in the house called Vishakha for one full year, which is not a good sign. And three tithis, actually, you know, lunations, twice meeting together in course of the same lunar fortnight, 15 days May. Therefore, during the duration of the fortnight is shortened by 2 days. 15 days, no? Duration is shortened by 2 days. So on the 13th day, both the moon and the sun are afflicted by Rahu. That means two eclipses in one fortnight, both lunar and the solar, indicate a great slaughter. That's why people are scared. So many is now, past 2 months we saw, so many, 2012 also, great Vinasha is predicted. Not the whole earth and all. And all quarters of the earth are covered by the showers of dust and they look very inauspicious. A lunar fortnight, normally, Paksha, Shukla Paksha, Krishna Paksha, normally consists of sometimes 14 days or usually 15 days or sometimes 16 days. Vyasa Bhagavan says, but I had never seen it before that the 13th day itself will be the new moon day. Amavasya. Ye kabhi nahi dekha bolte hai Vyasa Bhagavan. I have never seen it before. 13th day itself is Amavasya. Within these 13 days, both solar eclipse and lunar eclipse are taking place, took place. Oh, Dhritarashtra, mere jivan mein kabhi maine aisa nahi dekha. Amavasya on 13th day. Therefore, on account of their undergoing eclipses on unusual days, both the sun and the moon, they would cause a great slaughter of beings. On the 14th day of Krishna Paksha, Chaturdashi, there was a rain of flesh. The mouths of all the Rakshasas were filled with blood. There was no satisfaction of drinking blood for them. The waters of the rivers have become bloody. Great rivers are flowing in opposite direction. There were meteors, ulka, Arkajugirta, falling from the sky with a great speed and creating thundering sounds on the ground. After this night passes away, last but one day, no? Is raat bitne ke baad, the results of all your injustice will start yielding their results. Aapka jo anyaya hai na, abhi tak karke aaya na, uska phal kal subah se shuru hoga. Your injustice that you have done, O Dhritarashtra, will start yielding their fruits after the passing of this night. That is, all evil consequences now, Ashubha phalas will be given to you, will be started distributing to you from tomorrow morning. Dekhiye. Since darkness has enveloped on all sides, great maharshis, you know, andhakar, manme andhakar, bahar andhakar, bhitar andhakar. Nothing is seen. Meaning what? Everything is very, you know, I don't know whether you observed it or not. Nature also, on very auspicious days, a special shobha deti hai. If you are very sensitive. On festival days, look at sky, look at the environment, something you feel very, that you know, festival shobha, you can really feel it in nature. Not among the human beings and their celebrations and all, no. If you are sensitive. I don't know, I observed this. I always feel something special charm in the space, in the clouds, in the sun, in the environment, in the breeze. Something special, unique that day. I enjoyed many times. And some days, and you will definitely feel very, very, you know, depression, distress, lack of inspiration. Spread where? Everywhere around you. Not in the human beings I am talking, in the nature itself. I don't know whether you observed or not. Of a sensitive you must be. Same sky, same cloud, same sunrise, but that is something special. Don't say it's all in the mind and all. No. It is in nature. So, when looking at this darkness spread everywhere, right, great maharshis came out of their ashrams, Vyasa Bhagavan says, with the lanterns in their hands and started discussing the consequences of all the happenings and expressed their individual opinions as follows. Vyasa Bhagavan says, in every ashram, maharshis came out of their tapas, looked at the nature, looked at the happenings in the world, came out the lanterns in their hands, lights, and started discussing, expressing their opinions. What is this happening to the world? What are their expressions? We will see tomorrow. If I start again, I have to stop in between. Again, they are all speaking about omens only, all bad omens. But let us listen. Tomorrow we will continue. So, the Bhīṣma Parva beginning is like this. We will see tomorrow. 6 o'clock. I may be late by 5-10 minutes. I may be. Don't take it for granted and come late. I may not be late also. So, what should you do? You do your dharma. What is my dharma? I told honestly I may be late for 5-10 minutes. So, you should not scold me. But if I come on time, you cannot ask me, why are you on time? So, my dharma, I did it. Your dharma is? You stick to your dharma of time. Okay? That is called Mahābhārata says about dharma. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Arihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Arihi Om Sadgurunath Maharaj Ki Jai. Tomorrow morning, Taittiriya Upanishad.